Afghanistan is in the grip of a new and sinister campaign of violence. Young professionals are being deliberately singled out, targeted, and murdered. It is suspected that the killings are the work of insurgent groups like the Taliban and IS, who are targeting people, often women, trying to build a country based on democratic values.
خبرنگارا و فعالای مدنی و مردم تاثیر کرده در مجموعی بود که ما داینده افغانستان شما ممکن است جای نداشته باشین.
And the future of Afghanistan is exactly what is at stake. This year, the United States will withdraw its troops. Peace talks have so far failed to reach an agreement. And the government accuses the Taliban of using violence as leverage. But the Taliban deny involvement.
اگر طرف دیگر طالبان این فکر کنند که با جنگ دست بالا پیدا میکنن، اونمو محاسبه غلط است که در طول سالها باعث ادامه جنگ شده و افغانستان از نعمت رسیدن به صلح محروم ساخته.
یک قسم وحشت، دهشت و ترس را ایجاد بکنه که کسی که میخوان که صدای عدالت برپا بکنه اونا را بکوبن.
By targeting the very people standing up for women's rights, democracy, human rights and a free press, the fear is the gains of the last 20 years could all be lost. When these children were born, Afghanistan was labeled one of the worst places in the world to be a child due to conflict and poverty. The United Nations says it still is. This school provides support for 38 children with learning difficulties.
افغانستان ما متاسفانه به این اطفال هیچ توجه نشده. کل گروپ ما میخواه که به این طفلک ها و کوشش ما هسته که ای به خوبی به زندگی و نرمال مکتبا بره.
The school was born out of tragedy. It was opened in the name of Fatima Natasha Khalil, a human rights activist. Age 24, she was targeted and killed. Natasha was born in Pakistan, one of seven children. The family were refugees fleeing Taliban violence during Afghanistan's civil war.
یعنی یه چیز ما گفتم نه که ما ام پیدایش شالی به یادم میای.
ای اتاق فاطمه نتاشا است که امو جای به جای همه چیزایی که خودش دیزاین کرده بود سامانا مربوط خودش است. تخت خوابش است چون امرای همشری خود یک جای بود.
Natasha spoke six languages, and after graduating with a double degree from university in Kyrgyzstan, she returned to Afghanistan to decide on a career.
All the time, her ambitions was that she wants to work somewhere in a war zone. And then I would always tell her, welcome home, you don't have to go somewhere else. Her big goals, of course, were that she wanted to be the Secretary General of UN. But when she arrived to Kabul after her undergrad degree, she actually wanted to go back for her master's, but I told her to stay.
Natasha got a job with the Afghanistan Human Rights Commission.
و بسیار دختر پرتلاش بود و بسیار رویاهای کلان داشتم بر افغانستان و هم بر خودش و دختر بسیار نترس و شجاع بود و مرقمه که میخواست.
She was the youngest, so we were the least worried about her. This was her first job. She did not have this big public image of working either with the US government or Afghan government or any other international organization. She was just there to start her life. She was so excited. She would always say, Lema, this is a real thing. This is real life.
At 7:30 in the morning she was killed, Natasha was picked up by a government car to go to work. Within minutes of leaving the house, a bomb attached to the car exploded. Both she and her driver, Ahmad Javed Folad, were killed.
رفتم. پایای شدیدم. پایش زرد. امی دستکش از امی چادر یزید در سرش انداخته بود. دستکش و مو از تین خامکیش دیدم. ولی جرات نمیتونستیم که من روی شب ببینم. از خاطر ما گفتم اگه مرده خو مرده. اگه من روی شب ببینم این امی سانه ممکن در زندگی ما بسیار مرا رنج بده. اونه مخاطر ندیدم. رنگی ناخونش است که بسیار علاقه داشت و رو امور روز از خاطر من میگم که تازه بود که کی در ناخونایش بود کسایی که برای ازی غسل میدادن باز ما گفتن که ما از چی تو نخواستیم ولی من از صبح که میرفت خود دیدم که کی رنگی ناخونی ازی را از پای های ازی پاک کده
کاش که ایتور میشد که ما پیش از نتاشا از بین میرفتیم اینمی غم و اندوه را نمیدیدیم یعنی اصلا در زندگی خود ما پدر و مادر و خوارا و برادرای خود از دست دادیم اما نبودی پاتی ما بر ما بسیار چی بود یعنی از همه گی چی بود سختر بود چی بود بخاطر اینکه پاتی ما دختری ما بود که ما بسیار دوست داشت.
Natasha's killing is part of a chilling new tactic by insurgents who identify and target individuals for murder. The victims are all people working to rebuild the country after decades of violence. They are often young and women.
وضعیت سیاسی در مجموع در افغانستان در لحظه‌ای که ما قرار داریم پر از ابهام است. بسیار نگرانی وجود دارد در مورد آینده و این قتل‌های هدفمند همین فضای نگرانی و ابهام هم تشدید کردند. پیام مشخصش برای بعضی از اقشار برای خبرنگارا و فعالای مدنی و مردم تحصیل کرده در مجموعی بود که ما داینده افغانستان شما ممکن است جای نداشته باشید.
Natasha's generation have ambitions and aspirations for their country.
They are the generation of social media. They are the generation of internet. They are educated. They don't know how to be not connected to the world. This new generation whose life is like going outside, wearing whatever they want to wear and saying what they have on their mind.
But the targeted killings have shocked and frightened many of them.
Killing someone like her, a woman who was confident and could really stand up, so it could really serve a lot of purposes when they attack young people like her. A lot of her friends, they would say like, I'm done with Afghanistan. I can't do this. If they can kill someone like Natasha.
برای بسیار دخترها و بچه‌های همسن سال از او که می‌خواستند در افغانستان خطرناک است و می‌خواستند امی پیام‌ها را به اصطلاح غلط ثابت کنند. یک رقم مسلم شد که واقعا اینجا سخت است بسیار و بسیار خطرناک است. یک پیام بسیار یک دلشکستگی کلان فکر می‌کنم برای اون اصلی ایجاد کرد به خاطر آینده افغانستان.
Just months before Natasha was killed, in the Gulf state of Qatar, the United States had been talking to the Taliban.
As we speak, the United States is also working to end the war in Afghanistan, and we are bringing our troops home.
It's gone. It's gone, Joe.
After 9/11, the U.S. invaded Afghanistan, where the organizers of the attack were hiding. The Taliban, who ruled the country at the time, were overthrown. But they and other insurgents continued a campaign of violence. Twenty years later, by now America's longest war, both the US and the Taliban wanted American troops out. Fire. With the Taliban refusing to speak to the Afghan government, the U.S. decided to leave Afghan officials out of the process and talk only to the Taliban. They struck a deal on the terms of withdrawal.
کسانی که یک زمان با بسیار سادگی بزرگترین عملات تروریستی را در کشور ما سازماندهی کردند و دوستان ما را کشتند، همکارای ما را کشتند. اینا امروز به یک سطحی رسیدن از طرف آمریکا که با هم توافق میکنن، ولی تمام دنیا از او به عنوان یک دستاورد یاد میکرد. ما واقعا برام اید او روزا همیشه میگفتیم که دستاورد از این چی است.
The deal was an exchange of promises. The Taliban promised to reduce violence, not to attack US troops, and to start talking to the Afghan government.
The Afghan people are the biggest losers of the deal because they continued to be targeted attacked. The only positive side of the deal in terms of security, not of Afghanistan, but security in Afghanistan, was that the international military forces based in Afghanistan were not attacked. There were zero international losses in Afghanistan as a result of this deal.
In exchange, the Americans promised to get Taliban prisoners released and crucially committed to pulling out all their soldiers 14 months later on May the 1st, 2021. That deadline would define the year ahead. Helmand is the largest province in Afghanistan. It was the site of the most intense fighting between the Taliban and American and British troops. It remains a Taliban stronghold. Ilyas Dayi was an award-winning reporter for Radio Free Europe, well known for his bravery. Aged 14 when American troops arrived, he was 33 when he was killed. On the morning of his death, Ilyas was traveling in the capital Lashkargah when a bomb attached to his car exploded. Ilyas lived with three generations of his family. The youngest, his two-year-old daughter, Mehrabani, meaning kindness.
دای خپل د مور سره ډیر خوشاله وو او خپل لور یې ډیره نازول بل ویل زه غواړم چې زه لکه څنګه چې موږ خپل پلار ساتلي وو نازولي ویل زه هم خپل لور غواړم چې داسې نازولې وساتم
As part of the US Taliban deal, the Taliban had committed to reducing violence. In the weeks leading up to his death, Ilyas reported on a new Taliban offensive in Helmand. Soon after, his house was searched, and the day before he was killed, he sent a text to a colleague believing his life was in danger.
خمر زده په اړه موږ دې احساسوي د دې تشویش ځکه د خپل موټر چې کوي خپل امنیت به کته د چې کله وتاک په وتاک نه بده دی کله په کوټه کې بده دی کله په خپل پوتاک کې بده دی کله د مطالعه په وتاک کې بده دی یعنی ځان هم یو ځای نه بده دی کله بدلته په شهر کې به اوسې دی بیا به یو ته چانجیر کې ته اوسې دی یعنی په اوسه کې نه اوسې دی او هغه تعدیدونه چې
Ilyas is one of 12 journalists individually identified, targeted, and killed since the US Taliban deal of February 2020.
Journalists are the eyes and ears of people, they are the voice of people. Ruling powers are always very uneasy and uncomfortable with this, particularly despotic regimes. Like the Taliban, for example, who didn't even allow TVs back in the days when they were ruling. So silencing journalism is silencing the whole population.
But Ilyas would not be silenced.
د خوریشتیا ګوی وزوی ما چې چې خوریشتیا ول دروازه نه ول پلا به ګردا مرته ول زه ته د ما په دغه د څوک نه وښنه ول زما د یې نه لرم ول ته د آزادې د لرم د تا څوک وښنه
دا کته کې ول سوالی دا او دا د تنګي مرکزی سیمه ده
No one has claimed responsibility for Ilyas's killing. The Taliban deny involvement. Most targeted killings go unclaimed by any group.
Unknown armed men is the phrase that are being used, but my understanding is that there is a lot of indication that Taliban are party to these assassinations. There is also an indication that there are additional groups that are also part of it.
Off the record, hadiaqal. که کی پشت قتل هاست کی قتل ها را انجام میده یک دا میگن که بعضی ها کسایی هستن در داخل حکومت برای که طرفدار گروه های دیگه هستن میخواین روند صلح خراب شوه و نتیجه نرسه قصدنی کار میکنن بعضی ها میگن که طالبایی کار میکنن بعضی ها میگن گروه های دیگه هستن که ظاهرا نامای دیگه دارن اما وابستگی هایی با طالبا دارن این کار انجام میدن
Anissa Shahid is a famous TV journalist working for the popular Tolo News channel. She's known for her fearless reporting.
شما وقتی این رویدادها را میبینین بخواین نخواین وقتی تنها هستین روزها این چهره های آدم ها از یاد شما نمیره
این حادثه
شبا اینا به یاد شما میایه و این برای روان هیچ انسانی خوب نیست
خوب است ادامه میتون این موتر بودن شاید های اینی به ما گفتن که جسد سه زن را اونا خودشان بلند کردن به موترها انتقال دادن حدود 12 نفر در این رویداد زخمی شده
نمیشه زده بینده یا موتر یک ذره را زمین مردم های چی بود؟ چی بود؟ اینجا زده بینده دیگه چیه نیشه زده بینده یا نه؟
کلی سرکا حتما نگه کجا شدم
Despite losing colleagues to targeted killings, Anissa and her fellow journalists continue to work.
ای رویداد شده، آدم ها جان خود از دست دادن. و اما به عنوان یک خبرنگار، پیش خود خود ما اطور راضی نگه می دارم که ای رویداد اتفاق افتیده و ما باید ایره مستند بسازم.
سلام.
و فکر می کنم که تاریخ مستند و تلخ افغانستان است که باید ثبت شود. وقتی من لایف گزارش می دادم از محل رویداد به دل خود می گفتم خدا کنه برق نباشه در خانه و مادر من تلویزیون نبینه
همی پیشفرض تمام ما شما همی است که ممکن است کشته شویم و ممکن است هدف باشیم یک پیشفرض بر تمام کسایی است که در ساحه کاری ما کار میکنم همکارای ما در رسانه ها همچنان و در جامعه مدنی همچنان
Back in Doha, the Taliban and Afghan government had started direct talks, one of the commitments in the US-Taliban deal. This time, the US was not officially at the table, placing responsibility to find a settlement on the two parties from Afghanistan.
There is one priority for me as an Afghan, and that is to really see any efforts through non-violent means. That can end this current bloodshed and this current armed conflict. That's the only positive reflection that you could have when you see that at least two parties to conflict are sitting across each other.
یقین کامل داریم که صلح میان جمهوری اسلامی افغانستان و تحریک طالبان باعث اتحاد بزرگ ملی برای تأمین ثبات پایدار در کشور شده و قدرت و توان دفاعی و امنیتی کشور را در برابر تهدیدات داخلی و بیرونی به مراتب افزایش می‌دهد.
My personal view, not representing even my family because I just don't want their life to be in danger. I just have this problem even calling this process peace process because it's not a peace process, it's just a political settlement between the strongmen. Peace process would mean healing, transitional justice and listening to the victims. Nothing of that is happening. I'm getting so much hurt. It's like, because you just wanted to do this political settlement, you have to kill Natasha and like hers. Was it worth it to kill them? You could have done this settlement without killing them.
Oh.
اون نشست بسیار یک نشست عجیب غریب بود که او گپا و قصای خودش را داره مثل یک کمدی تراژیک و وحشتناک و یک فیلم که هیچ نمیفهمیده ایجا چه اتفاقی افتاده.
فرهناز فروتن was at the talks, reporting for One TV, a news channel in Kabul.
خط سرخ من قلم و آزادی بیان من است. خط سرخ شما چیست؟
Farahnaz is well known as an activist in Afghanistan. She runs a social media campaign called My Red Line. She traveled the country asking people what they could and could not accept in a peace deal. Their red lines.
یا یه هر کس یا یک روسری سرخ، یک چادر سرخ، یک چیز میگیرید. صدای همه گیره میگرفتیم که پرسان کنیم که چی حقم یک صلح بر افغانستان خوب است.
At the talks in Doha, Farahnaz interviewed a member of the Taliban. She was not wearing a veil, and this attracted a lot of media attention.
موقف طالبان در این مورد چی است؟ این عدالت برای قربانیان. سوال میکردم، هیچ طرف من نمیدید و تصور کنین شما در رو بروی ماستن، ما به در میبینم، به دیوار میبینم، به لایت میبینم، به این چوب میبینم، مگم به شما نمیبینم.
چقدر مهم است صدای از یا شاهین صاحب دموزاد؟
چون شما گناه هستین، چون شما زن هستین، چون شما تنها کاری کردین این است که هوا بسیار گرم بوده، امروز دلتان نخواسته یک چیز را در سرتان بندازین.
Two months later, Farahnaz got a call saying she was on a hit list. Her life was in danger.
فقط گفت چی شده؟ گفت من نمیخوام کشته شم. امیر گفت امیر رفتم. باز یک دفعه جدی میگرفتم همه چیز، واقعا یک حالت روحی غیر قابل قبول.
Farahnaz is now living in the United States. Like dozens of young professionals fearing they could be targeted, she left Afghanistan, but it was not an easy decision.
گاز گفت که پدرم هیچی خودم نمیره، گپاش بسیار گپاش برم سخت تمام شد. برم گفت که بچیم سوال ها در این ملک ما مبارزه کردیم، استاده شدیم، زدیم، گفت ما پیر شدیم. گفت که نمیخوایم که یک روز از خانه وقتی که پایین میری یک انفجار شوه و یک چسبکی زیر موترت بانن و من از این صدا بشنم که تو تکه تکه شدی. و میگفت که یک جای برو، یک زندگی برات جور کن، یک مدت درس بخوان. یکان
Certain she would be back soon, Farahnaz made the most of precious moments with friends and family.
دیم شاید امروز روز آخری باشه که زندگی میکنیم، پس بیاین خوب زندگی کنیم، خنده کنیم، رقص کنیم، شاد باشیم، لباس خوب بپوشیم، هر لحظه را رقم زندگی کنیم که آخرین لحظاتی است که در زندگی میکنیم. همون شب یک شب بسیار دردناک بود. همه گی مثل که غیر از ما فهمیده بودن که میرم و دیگر شاید نیایم یک مدت طولانی.
In Washington, a new American president was sworn in.
Preserve, protect, and defend
the Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the United States.
So help you God.
So help me God.
Congratulations, Mr. Thank President. You.
There was one question on everyone's mind. Would the new President Biden honor President Trump's commitment to pull out U.S. troops by May 1st? The White House said they would review the deadline. Meanwhile, targeted killings in Afghanistan continued.
تا هنوز حدود 80-85 روز گذاشتم. امی 80-85 روز هر ثانیه. هر ثانیه در یاد ما است. اگر در خوابم باشم، در خوابم در یاد ما است. دفتر کارم باشم، در موترم باشم، سر نمازم باشم، هر جایی که باشم چون یک برادر بود که قسم برادر باز پیدا نمیشه.
یوسف رشید was head of the Free and Fair Election Forum. He was a leading, impartial voice who spoke out on what he saw as threats to democracy.
هر روز ژورنالیست ها متاسفانه هدف قرار می گیرند. حالا اینجا مدنی در خطر هستند. اینال این یک ارزش ما که زیر خطر است.
بدون شک که همکاره ما در کمیسیون مستقل انتخابات تلاش خود کردن که
He believed that political rights and freedoms were for everyone.
اگر پروسه صلح به خیر و موافقت تمام شوه او طرف خط که مخالفین حکومت هستند طالبا اونا میگه حق دارند این کشور باید سهم سیاسی خود داشته باشند در نظام نظامی که شکل گرفته ارزش ها باید حفظ شوه. نگه همیشه اینجا می آمد می نشست آغاز به کار می کرد دوستای رسانه می آمدن همکاره ما از جامعه مدنی.
یوسف's high profile raised security concerns for Sameh, his cousin and driver.
سامی جان است. یوم یک بچه بسیار خوش‌سیرت و خوش‌خلق بود. همراه من گاهی میگفت که رشید باید یک موتر زیری داشته باشه که حداقل در جایی که رفت آمد میکنیم اگر حمله میشکم و مرمی یا گلوله داخل موتر داخل نشوه و ما محفوظ باشیم. ما هم رشید صاحب که میگفتیم اونا هم میگفت که من یک آدم هستم که در اجتماع کوشش میکنم مثبت تمام باشم و فعال جامعه مدنی هستم مدافع بشر هستم مرکز غرض نمیگیره.
آخر ورست کله ما ول ده دته ز بکوټه کې نفس ملته کوټه ترغه وي خدای په امان ما کله آخر ورست کله ده د لکوټې وته ما یو بل سره خبرې کولې خو بیا په بيخي مزري بل رقم سو وته مور بسي دی باندې وته مزه په نوس مز څنګه وته خو زه بسي وته مان ته زینو پر لاړم بيخي هغه مې رانه سو څنګه زور سي وایرلم او زه خپلم په نوس سي آخر زال دې سي ویلم
الکتی څنګه زوی چې دا تخسي چې
معمول دیگر روزا در میدان در روزه استاد میشو خدافیزی هر روزه میگرفت ای ترنا بکن آقا میکه ای امروز یک دوستی قدم پیش آمد ما در اینجا شتا بودم اینجا شتا بودم مگتم خدا چی تو امروز در دلم گشت که چی تو پیش آمد یک دوستی قدم پیش.
Minutes after leaving the house to go to work in the car, Yusuf and his cousin were killed by gunmen.
در ایران زیاد هم روشن خاطره دارم. اون روش چیزی اکثرا رفت آمد میکردم به دفتر خانه.
That morning, Yusuf's brother used his own car that he had recently bought.
ما هم دیگه از اون روز هم روشن نبودم و اونا دوتا شهید میشن. رشید سای و پسر کاکا هم سمی جان. ما نجات پیدا کردم. یکانه عامل نجات ما همین موتره که هست ایره ما اگر چه در پلانم نبود.
یوسف was killed here in this residential street.
امو تورستا به گفته بعضی مردم میگه از امو طرف میه یار تعقیب میکنه دقیق در این قسمت که میرسه تایرهای جلای موترشون از این جمع میگذره یکشان از این قسمت بالشون فایر میکنه شلیک میکنه یک شورم در این طرف رشید صاحب در این قسمت 12 گله به فرق و سینه میخورن اینجا باجا شهید میشه.
یوسف's murder has left the family without a loved one and deprived the country of his talent and experience.
کاراکتر از یک سیل میکنم یک آدم بسیار آینده درخشان داشت که من سیل میکنم. یک نخبگیر در من دشان از این میدیدم که حتماً یک آدم با تجربه آدم لایق آدم ورزیده به جامعه خواد شدی و همون تو دشانش دیده میشد.
لار لکه او غار غنده انسان شده ای لکه تا کس انسان لحظه ورکی خبال دیوار خبال شده یو سوگ یو ملاتر.
Jalalabad, the capital of the eastern province of Ningarhar. Another mother speaks to journalists about her grief. Her daughter and two other TV interpreters were shot dead in coordinated attacks, just months before the US deadline to withdraw troops. And with no political settlement in sight, targeted killings increased. Here alone, within days of each other, three health workers, a doctor, and a police officer were also killed. They were all women.
Ningarhar is a borderlands province. It's one of the provinces that, in terms of political economy, have a very significant importance. It's a center of revenue, it's a center of trade. Women in Ningarhar province are very active. Yes, they are covering, but they are highly educated, and the millennial women are unbeatable.
One of those women was Malala Maivand. She was shot and killed in December on her way to work as a presenter at NCOS TV. Known as a defender of women's rights, she was named after Malala Maivand, an Afghan hero celebrated in epic poetry for her bravery in the Second Anglo-Afghan War.
Medal work, that the Malala Maivand dawlati medal de, che zman klarte ibial ta dalik, medal yaga de yaga medal de che Malala the Maivand pa jagra ki. انګریزانو تماتی ورکړه او دا دولتي مډال لاغه فلسفي سره تړاو لري چې بیا ملالی په نشتون کې د ملالی په نوم شو
د ژوند تر پای به ځان سره ساتم.
Malala was well known and a role model for young women who would write her fan mail.
دا یادګار د محبت ځان سره واخله د ژوندون شمه به مړه وي زه به نه یم ګرانې او زړه ته رانږدې خورې کلسم جانې السلام علیکم ګرانې ملګرې نن واقعیت.
These messages now provide beautiful memories for the family scarred by Malala's murder.
چ ملاله لکوره وته من کور کې ناست او ما غشي به لا وختي وژمې او هغه به جدیری وختي وي د ډز غږونه شو کله چې من ضرور مې بیرون وته یعنی هغه څوک چې په همدې شیبه کې ما ورسره د ښې ورځې هیله مې ورته وکړله ورته مې ویلې چې خورې ته ښه ورځ ولري په داسې یو وضعیت کې پرته وه چې سروینو کې پراته وا او هغه خپل ژوند بایللی و.
Malala's murder was claimed by the so-called Islamic State. An arrest was made on the day of her killing, but months later, the family say they have heard nothing more.
وس مرته وي چې پلانکي پلانکي ته را پړې وس مې پنه کېږي عجز يم بي وسه يم زه خو بده ځان وساتم کنه زه خپل دوست دشمن سره پیژنم.
The experience of Malala's family reflects a wider frustration.
خانواده ها همیشه گلایه دارن از اینکه حکومت به موقع نمیپردازه یا اینکه عاملین دسکین نمیشن یا اینکه حکومت عاملین نمیشناسه ولی پیگیری نمیکنه.
But the authorities say they are working hard to capture the attackers. Every Saturday, government officials update the press on investigations.
در قسمت تروای هدفمندم
ارقام را که تنها از می هفته اما میشه که براتون امو ارقامش بگویم 77 نفر دستگیر شدن تنها در شهر کابل از اینا 15 نفر کسایی هستند که در ترورهای هدفمند و معنای چسبکی دست داشتن اعتراف هم کردن و راه بسیار چیدی که باید ما در مقابل از این مبارزه کنیم این است که اینمی شبکه ها شناسایی شود و دستگیر شود.
But for Malala's family and others, this is not enough. Some believe accountability reaches right to the top.
This president has to apologize to the victims because Taliban's are killer, we don't expect from them. But we voted for democracy. So for us, he has to say, I'm sorry, I was not able to provide you basic security. That has to come to the victims of the family.
دا د کور جامې دي چې کله به کور کې و دغه تل دادته چې کور کې به یو جوړه جامې غوستي چې را بغلې غوډې ډیره پراخې وي ډیره راحت جامې بوي هم دا به غوستي دا چې په کومه شپه شهیدی د لا پاندې شپه و غوستلې زه دا سوام کاش کې دا یو شی برا شي چې غزمه پکې یاد نشي او زلک دارام سا واخلم کله چې دا سبات شهیدی د لپدیش په زور سره ناستو ما یعنی دا غی لاسونه ما ډیر دی خپل لاسونه سره هم دسی لوبي می ور سره کولې دا غی د لاسونه سره اره شیبه چې هغه ما ته را یادیږي یعنی د ژوندینی یو خاطرې ما ته را یادیږي بیخي هغه حالت زه تاسو ته نشم ویلی چې زه څه ډول یو حالت کې بیا قرار لرم
Just before the May deadline to withdraw US troops, the White House announced it would be delayed by 6 months to the symbolic date of September 11th.
It's time to end America's longest war. It's time for American troops to come home.
This time, the president put no conditions on the Taliban. Many believe this leaves the US with far less influence on the ongoing talks between the Taliban and the Afghan government.
The leverage that the United States has on the Taliban, on the current political situation that is existing, is quite a significant leverage, and they can use it to stop the bloodshed. They had that leverage, and in a very irresponsible way, by unconditionalizing this whole process, they have not really contributed to end this bloodshed.
If there is no agreement, if the talks break down, and I'm not anticipating that, the war going on for so long, so many Afghans dying, enough is enough. I think that's the expectation of the people. I think they're not only under pressure from me or from the United States or the international community, but also from the Afghan people. And I hope that that would have a salutary effect on both sides and that they put the country first.
بهترین وضعیت همی خواد بود که ما پیشرفت گفتگوهای صلح داشته باشیم بحثا کم جدید تر شود و واقعا به محتوای بحثا برسیم این کلانترین نگرانی بر فکر میکنم اکثریت مردم افغانستان است که ماهای آینده ما شاهد خونبارتر شدن جنگ بسیار خونبار باشیم
The hope for the children of Afghanistan is that they grow up in a more peaceful country. But if targeted killings continue, the fear is that the next generation may be just too intimidated to aspire to become the journalists, human rights workers, and civil activists of tomorrow.